This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
That means all that great acting they tried on offense went for naught, didn't it? Because you have to try and influence them. Make them think that you're doing something else. Make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by and then setting up the screen and getting downfield. Didn't happen at all. Give a lot of credit to the defense for not tumbling to that one.
And a gain there of 11 yards.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
This is Freeman on first and 10. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
While there's no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
Freeman again. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave him with a third down and 6 to go.
No, that wasn't an explosive run. That wasn't one that took it all the way to the house. But, boy, for a team that's had trouble running it the entire game, that's the kind of run they need, hopefully, to get themselves kick-started.
And on third down, the Colts have added an extra defensive back.
Flooding the passing lanes.
From the gun, on third down, Ryan. He goes underneath to Freeman. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll be fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down.
There are so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shedding skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day, get the blocker away, and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. 10-zip our score. The NFL on EA Sports continues right after this message.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Colts in possession of the football to begin quarter number 2, but they face a second and long to start things out. To the ground, this time with Jones. And he's able to get up here to the 26. It'll be a gain of 11, and that'll lead here to a third down.
It seemed like the situation was second and a mile to go for a first down, which screams what? Throw the football. You got to pass in order to try and pick up that kind of yardage. But in this case, they ran a tendency breaker because the tendency is for defenses to be out there and be set up for a pass. So you break tendency and actually run the football. That changes everything because if you're able to find a crease, you often have bigger guys working against smaller guys downfield. They picked up excellent yardage there to bring up a third down.
Out of the gun now on third down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Now the ball comes loose, and the Falcons grab it. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman, 43 yards. And the Falcons draw a bit closer. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
They'll go again to Jones. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. Grady Jarrett with the tackle.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route. You are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well come down with the football and absorb whatever else happens after that.
Well, that'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
On the counter, Devontae Freeman. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result, because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter, you're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him, sat there waiting for him and made the play.
And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. On third down, Ryan looking for his running back, and he's got it. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. And this one is right through, and that will knot us up at 10. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Escaping the pressure right. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll be second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
So second down, 3 yards to go now. He'll drop to throw. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. Touchdown, Indianapolis. T.Y. Hilton, 60 yards. And the Colts have taken the lead. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. Well, sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. And that's almost like one of your Turkey Bowl games, isn't it? Just go long,
backyard.
Man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Point after try forthcoming. Oh, this is blocked. The touchdown, here's Pat McAfee to kick. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board.
Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Falcons are an extra point away from moving out in front. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And, partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates.
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. But he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him. And after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
I know it's easy to kind of shrug off a blocked extra point, but this game is shaping up to be a tight one. The second half, this could prove crucial.
Yeah, we might look back on